Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In this video series, we will be covering deduplication engines. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos, and you can follow us on Instagram. As a CommVault administrator, it is crucial for you to monitor the performance of the deduplication database. You can monitor the deduplication savings, the capacity of the deduplication database, DDB, the DDB performance, the status of the DDB, and the space that is available on the DDB disk, and these can be checked at various levels. This monitoring is useful to manage the DDB, based on the DDB performance, the DDB status, and the data growth on the DDB. From the CommCell browser, expand storage resources. Click Deduplication Engines. The Deduplication Engines summary is useful to monitor the deduplication savings across multiple storage policy copies in the CommCell, and the amount of data written on the disk after deduplication. Please note, the summary information is available only after you perform the backups against the associated storage policy. Charts displays deduplication savings for the top 10 storage policy copies, based on the size of the application data. The Deduplication Engines table provides the following information: the storage policy and its associated copy, the total amount of the application data size, the total amount of data written, the amount of deduplication savings, the number of jobs that ran on that copy, the amount of free space available on the library associated with the storage policy copy, the retention criteria, that is days and cycles, set on the copy. Let's check what options available on the deduplication engines. Right-click on Deduplication Engines. New Global Deduplication Storage Policy. This option would launch Create Global Deduplication Policy Wizard, using which you can create a new global deduplication policy. This is one other way to create global deduplication policy. The next option to discuss is Synchronize All DDBs. This option is very much useful to fix the deduplication data consistency and synchronize the components. Well, if deduplication is enabled for any storage policy, the following three components need to be synchronized. They are CommServe database, deduplication database, and data blocks on disk. There might be circumstances where these three components can be out of sync, and this option helps to fix it. The scenarios causing out of sync could be CommServe, DR, disaster recovery restore. Restoring from previous DR backup might cause both CommServe database and the DDB out of sync, and might result in backup failures. Unplanned shutdown of the media agent hosting the DDB. When backups are running, the signatures of the backups are stored in the DDB. If there was unplanned shutdown of the media agent hosting that DDB, the DDB and disk will become out of sync and result in backup failures. Backup disk has unreadable or missing data. The DDB pointing to data blocks that are unreadable or missing might result in restore or auxiliary copy job failures. The DDB is flagged in maintenance mode when there is an inconsistency found between the three components. Synchronize All DDBs option: resynchronize the deduplication database to bring the DDB online and revert it to a reusable state from maintenance mode. How DDB resynchronization works. This is from a bird's eye perspective. The data in the DDB is validated against the CommServe database to ensure that both the databases are synchronized. If the CommServe database and the DDB are not synchronized, the resynchronization process removes the additional data entries in the DDB to reconcile inconsistencies in the CommServe database. When the DDB entries are removed successfully, the DDB is marked online. When DDBs are in maintenance mode, pruning will not happen, and backups or auxiliary copy jobs cannot access the DDB and go into waiting state. Use DDB resynchronization in the following situations: to reconcile inconsistencies between the DDB and the CommServe database. You want to bring the DDB online from maintenance mode. To avoid the need to seal the DDB after the CommServe DRS tour. The DDB sealing can be avoided only if the CommServe DRS tour was completed using the DR backup within the past 5 days. The next is the View menu, which has two options: DDB Verification Jobs, DDB Verification Job History Filter Window. Let's select Default Options and click OK. Admin Job History for DDB Verification. From here, you can view all the DDB verification jobs that ran for all storage policies configured with deduplication. Deduplicated data verification cross-verifies the unique data blocks on disk with the information contained in the DDB and the CommServe database. Verifying deduplicated data ensures that all jobs that are written as unique data blocks to the storage media are valid for a store or other operations. The jobs containing invalid data blocks are marked with the failed status. These invalid unique data blocks will not be referenced by the subsequent jobs. As a result, new baseline data for the invalid unique data blocks is written to the storage media. View DDB Space Reclamation Jobs. DDB Space Reclamation Job Filter. Let's select Default Options and click OK. Admin Job History for DDB Space Reclamation Job. We have no job history, as we have never run it. We will try to do it later and add it to another video. This job helps to reclaim idle space on disk mount paths that do not support sparse files by deleting the invalid data blocks and the orphan chunks. We will discuss it in more detail when we get to the topic. We will discuss disk pool in our next video. We will end this video here. Please hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.